I'm Trevor Alonzo. Today being Cyber Monday, and with malls almost being a thing of the past, I'm going to review the horror sci-fi comedy, Chopping Mall. Don't let the title fool you. It's not a slasher, and no one gets chopped up. The plot is about a mall with high-tech robots for its security at night. They are programmed to subdue thieves and anyone that breaks in with non-lethal force, even though they're armed with high-powered lasers. With lots of safety protocols, nothing can possibly go wrong. Well, if that was the case, we wouldn't have a movie. A lightning storm strikes a control computer on the rooftop, causing the robots to instead kill everyone they come across. And of course, during the same night, 8 teenagers that work at the mall decide they want to stay and have a party at the mattress store. Needless to say, the robots go after the teens. But instead of just being helpless teenagers in an average horror movie, the teenagers actually fight back and try to defend themselves. This movie is very 80s. Because let's face it, malls have changed since then, and it's full of 80s cheese. This low-budget movie was produced by Julie Corman, who was the wife of Roger Corman, which there are a few homages to Roger Corman throughout the movie, including a cameo by Dick Miller. Directed by Jim Ronowski, some of the teenagers you might recognize from other horror movies, such as Kelly Maroney from Night of the Comet. It's sort of rumored that she got this part because of that movie. 80s scream queen Barbara Crampton is in this as well. She admits it that in a few scenes she felt like she hammed it up. All of the teenagers turn in a good performance in this movie. For this type of movie, not to say they're bad actors any other time, but this is a fun B-movie. The pacing isn't dragged out or slow at all. And once the movie starts, it doesn't stop, which is good for this type of movie. The kills by the robots are great in this. I really don't want to spoil anything for this, and I'm definitely not spoiling anything by saying the best kill in the movie is definitely the head exploding. The security robots in this movie were made to look like an updated version of Cog from the movie Cog. Some of the design ideas also came from toy robots. This movie's title was changed a few times. While writing and filming the movie, it was called Robots. Then it was changed to, and also originally limited released as, Killbots. But it did badly, and some people thought, because of the title, some people might think, oh, this is a kid's movie, even though it's clearly an R-rated horror movie, because companies don't know how people really think. But I guess they were right on some level, because they released it as Chopping Mall, and it did better, even though some of the actors suggested Laser Mall would actually make more sense. And this poster definitely gets more attention, even though it definitely gives off the wrong idea that it's more of a chopping slasher movie. The movie was filmed at Sherman Oaks Galleria, which you might recognize from Fast Times at Ridgemont High, Commando, and Back to the Future. The mall security hated this production, but the owner loved them, which allowed them to do a lot more. They just couldn't damage the mall. They also filmed a movie during closing hours, so basically at night, just like the movie takes place. For this movie, you get what you came for. Teens having fun in a mall, killer robots going crazy, action in a mall from teens versus robots. The Blu-ray offers tons of great features. It's actually treated with the same respect as some great classic movies, with 3 different commentaries, an isolated music score, even an interview with the biggest Chopping Mall fan, and also an interview with a killbot, which is kind of funny. Okay, spoilers! For a 35-year-old movie, which I won't say much, it's better to actually go into this movie cold not knowing very much. And you'll have more fun that way. So, spoilers, all the robots do get destroyed, but I won't say how. And I'm not gonna say who survives. For a B-movie, this really does deliver all the fun you expect, and all that you want. So for that, I give this movie a 10 out of 10 killbots. If you like 80s sci-fi horror comedies, or 80s cheese, which this does deliver a lot of cheese, you won't be disappointed. Go check it out. Thank you for watching my video.